Hi Cancer, welcome to How Love Tarot. This is your May 2022 weekly reading. Now, I have for you the Page of Coins in the present position, the Ten of Wands in the present position, and the High Priestess in the reverse in the present position. The Page of Coins and the Ten of Wands have come out in the upright position. Spirit, please bring it forward. What's going on in this reading? Now, Cancer, this is a general reading, but as I was shuffling, I was already kind of getting quite a lot of information here. So forgive me if I kind of go down one route with this reading. But please change up the situation as it pertains to you, because it is a general reading. I feel here in the Page of Coins, Cancer, that you're going to be made an offer that is going to cause you a lot of conflict. I feel as if this offer is something that is not something that you want. I feel here that in the High Priestess in the reverse position, I feel that there could be a very logical decision that you're going to have to make about this situation. It does feel like it is a, you know, the offer that's being made is, it's either person, place, or thing, or whatever it is, but it just feels to you that it's not something that you want to participate in. But, you know, here with the High Priestess in reverse is very significant. For a Cancer to have the High Priestess in reverse, it indicates that you're not making an intuitive decision, you're making a very logical decision. Now, just so we're clear, that is not a wrong thing to do, because in life we are in a physical body having a physical experience, and yes, you want to use your intuition and your gut, but sometimes we do have to make a logical decision, a practical decision, a professional decision, or even just a wise decision that is not necessarily coming from emotions or gut instinct. So let me give an example. You know, let's say saving for retirement is not a gut instinct. It's not a psychic intuition decision. It is a decision out of practical, pragmatic means. And that's what I mean here in the Page of Coins. Spirit makes me feel here that this could have to do with a job, money, something like that, or industry. The other storyline that I was getting that was coming through extremely strongly, it's not now, but as I was shuffling here, it felt like for those of you in a love situation, it's somebody that's going to come forward that you were considering at one point and kind of now you're not. Or it's somebody that wants to come forward to you that you're using your logic. You're using your logic, you're ignoring your intuition, okay? You're ignoring your intuition. There's something about the situation that's not sitting right with you, and but there's some guilt here. There's some guilt in regards to them. You know that it's a very painful, for some reason, it's very difficult for this person to come forward to you. And so a little bit out of guilt, and a little bit, you know, because it feels like somewhere along the line here, you said, I want to be with you, or something to that effect, or yes, in some way. But now you're looking at your circumstances, perhaps their circumstances, the things around you, and you're making this logical decision of, and it's a very difficult decision for you, because it puts you in a lot of mental anguish. Now, whether this has to do with person, place, or thing, I feel like the same kind of outcome. You're in your mind a lot in regards to what you should do. In the Strength position, we've got the Two of Coins in the upright, we got the Five of Wands in the upright position, and we got the Ten of Swords in the upright position. So what the strength is that you're really striving for balance in your life. Your life is very out of balance, Cancer, and it has been for such a long time. And so you've been making a lot of decisions, very tough decisions, to bring your life back into balance. And that is a strength of yours. New things are growing and new possibilities are opening up. There's a lot of but both internal and external balance and financial balance and wealth building going on here. In the Five of Wands, in the strength position, Spirit, do you want to bring that forward? Can you clarify for me here? I just want to point out the overall energy here in your reading is actually the Six of Coins, and we kind of see this reiterated in the strength position in regards to the overall energy is about balance. And I'll see if I can come back to that. But Spirit, do you want to please clarify the Five of Wands and why it's sitting in the strength position for me? Thank you. Page of Cups. This has to do with something that you love. You're very conflicted about it. And again, person, place, or thing, it's something that you're engaged in that you love, and there's a lot of conflict in regards to be kind of like this feels like the beginning of something, of a path of some sort, and it feels like you were going down another path, and now this thing kind of presents itself. And in your strength, what it shows is the conflict is, do you go with the heart or the head, right? Do you go with your gut or do you go with your heart or the head? There's some situations here. Spirit, can you clarify the Ten of Swords for me, why it's in the strength position? Thank you. So we've got the King of Wands in the reverse. This person's disappointed you. This person, place, or thing, whatever it pertains to, there's a history of disappointment here in the strength position. And promises, this person, place, or thing did not give you what it was supposed to. So Ace of Cups is in the reverse. And so this is why you're so conflicted, because it does feel like you opened up to the possibility of this experience, and you were trying to gain balance in this experience from engaging in that. But what you are looking at is historically what has happened in this scenario, and what has happened, and you went into this from a very pure, humble energy of engagement and hopeful expectation, and just really just putting your best foot forward. And it feels here in the strength position, it just has caused you a lot of anguish and stress. It does feel like this person really disappointed you. I feel like there may have been lies here. I feel like there were empty promises. I feel like there was just kind of this I'm gonna kind of like leading you on is what it feels like. It feels like with the Ace of Cups in reverse, the King of Wands in the reverse, and that's clarifying the Ten of Swords here in the strength position, is that this person, place, or thing is it just, and I want to say person, right? Because if I feel like they're a hypocrite. I feel like there is a lot of seducing in the energy of whatever this is. And this is where, they're offering you this kind of, they're back to in the present position. This is historical what's gone on with this situation, but here they are again, just saying, I'm gonna, there's so much abundance here. I have so much to offer. And again, this could be a relationship, employer, business. I don't know what it is, whatever it pertains to, but there's definitely a history here. And that's why you're going, that makes more sense now why you're going with your head rather than, just instinctively, because you have to process what has happened here. And that is sitting in the strength position. So it is actually a strength that you're not using your gut instinct, but you're using this kind of, logic is very important. We all think that following your intuition is the best thing that you can ever do. And yeah, in most scenarios, that is what you want to do. But life is all about balance, right? And it is important that there's a reason why we have a mind, there's a reason that we have a heart, there's a reason we have our gut instinct, and there's a reason why you have to switch into those different things when they're appropriate. And here I see you switching into that logical energy of making a logical decision, because if you're to make a gut instinct decision, an emotional decision, it will probably be the wrong decision. Here in the challenge, again, they're showing up. We've got the Seven of Swords in the reverse. And so you won't be played for a fool again. You know this person is a liar, is they gaslight you, or the situation is not genuine. And so we have the Seven of Swords in the reverse, sitting in the challenge position. We have the Moon in the reverse, we have the Knight of Coins in the reverse, and we have the King of Swords in the upright position. So there's kind of some repetitive energy here where it feels like this has been discussed in regards to the lack of fulfillment or the lack of promises that was happening. It does feel like in the challenge position, you have to put down boundaries here with the Moon card in the reverse. And it does feel like in the Knight of Coins in the reverse, it's as if, you know, that where you have been quite tentative and putting down those boundaries, very quiet and putting down those boundaries, you're being much more firm with it. And that's why we have the King of Swords energy, because it's a little bit confrontational, at least it comes across that way. I don't feel like there's arguments or fights, but because of the Knight, King of Swords here in the challenge, it does show that you have to speak a truth. And speaking of the truth could be as simple as, I'm sorry, but this is not what I want. I'm sorry, I have to kind of refuse this. It's not a, you know, it's not you, it's me kind of thing. So that's in your energy. Here in the outcome, we got the Magician in the upright position, we got the Tower in the reverse, and we got the Ace of Wands in the reverse, and we got the Six of Swords in the reverse. In the outcome, you are not choosing this person, place, or situation. You're most certainly not choosing it, because here Spirit wants me to bring back the Six of Coins. It's not bringing you balance. It's not bringing you what it was supposed to bring you. Here with the Tower in reverse, it shows that you're not trying to, you know, the Magician is. Spirit, do you want to bring it forward? Can you just give me one more card on the Magician? Give me one more card on the Magician. I know what I'm trying to say, but I'm getting. Thank you. In this situation, in the context of this reading, Cancer, the Magician right here is this Page of Coins person right here in the outcome. This person is, place or thing, is extremely manipulative in nature. And so we have the Seven of Coins in the reverse. The outcome is this person is going to have empty promises again. And what's happening is they're saying, you know, this and this and this will happen, and you'll get this, this and this, and I'm promising you the world, right? Is what they're doing. But the Seven of Coins is in reverse. There's no new beginning here with the Tower in the reverse, and with the Ace of Wands in reverse, again, there's such a lack of passion and authenticity in this experience that, you know, we've got the Six of Swords in reverse, nothing changes. It's just going to continue to produce, it's not going to take you in the direction that you want to go, which is balance. So, quite a interesting week in regards to needing to have to make this type of decision. And I feel, you know, it's going to be done gently. Gently, gently does it, Cancer. Gently, gently. I don't feel like there's going to be a confrontation. I just feel like it's very difficult for you here in the Knight of Swords to, you know, gently say, you know, I'm sorry, but this is not for me, because it feels like you want to fly under the radar over here in the Page of Coins energy when this person comes towards you. I feel like there's a part of you that knows it's going to happen. I feel like there's a part of you that knows that this person's going to propose the same scenario once again. And it's very, very difficult for you to be to put the boundary down and just be true to yourself, because there's a risk here. Spirit, do you want to give me the Knight of Swords, what I'm picking up in the risk for Cancer? And thank you. There's a risk here, because it's a Two of Cups, right? And the all right, I need one more. I need one more, Spirit. So I got the challenge is the King of Swords, them having to put down their boundaries, Cancer having to put down the boundary. The risk is the Two of Cups. One more card, please. Thank you. Things will not change. Yeah. So the risk is that, you know, there's a part of you that wants to believe what this person, place, or thing is going to promise you. But with the Death card in reverse, it just shows, once again, we've got this energy of, let me just try and pull this back a little bit. We've got this, we've got this energy of the Knight of Swords, the King of Swords, where there's the hope that what they're promising is authentic and it will happen, but in the challenge position, it shows that it won't. It shows that there's no transformation in this situation. So you're going to have to make a hard decision. I feel like you've already made the decision. And that's why, you know, it's kind of like you were doing it quietly, and but this person's going to bring it to the surface. But ultimately, you know, what your goal is not their goal. What your goal is achieving balance in your life, achieving that through things that will bring, you know, abundance begets abundance. And where, you know, what I feel here is like a drought of whatever it is, a drought of emotions, a drought of authenticity, a drought of abundance, a drought of reciprocation. This really feels like a situation that is not a good situation to stay in, and that is not where you are in your life. You're not about somebody else's dreams for you. You're about, you know, and again, this person, place or thing, I keep saying person, because it does feel like a person that's saying this to you, but it just feels like they've got their own agenda, they've got their own interests at heart. And one of the things they do to not just you, but to everybody that they come in contact with, they do the same thing. This is a pattern in their energy, which is promising the world and giving nothing in return. But in their mind, it's kind of delusional, because in their mind, it shows me in their energy that they're doing you a favor, right? And when they don't follow through in the way that it's expected, that they said that they would follow through, they then gaslight, meaning that it's your fault that they didn't follow through. It's toxic energy, Cancer. And I think you know that, and it doesn't belong here where you're going, which is all about making decisions that are going to bring you abundance, joy, peace. And I feel like you're going after this very, very strongly and extremely committed to it. And so I don't feel like this is going to be like a, yeah, it's going to cause initial kind of stress when you have to kind of verbalize that boundary. But I do feel ultimately it doesn't fit into the plan of your life, and that it will be easier than you think to walk away. Cancer, I hope this reading was helpful. Please join me next week for your next weekly reading. I hope this reading helped. You take care.